My lab usually tries to find genetic causes of allergic diseases. And we saw a bunch of families that were sent to us because they looked like there might be something running in the genes. They had a lot of symptoms that really were very disruptive, and they also had some bone and joint problems. Within an individual family, there might be one person who had everything on the list, and a mom or a dad who, yeah, they kind of remembered having lots of belly pain throughout their life, but they just thought that was normal. And then we drew a lab that made it clear that they had something running in their family that no one had ever seen running in a family before, and the lab was called serum tryptase. We were able to do a special kind of a genetic analysis that lets us find the address of where the problem is. And once we found the address of where the problem is, we made a special test to actually see the fact that they had an extra copy of tryptase in their genes.
And it turned out that all the families and all the individuals in those families who had high tryptase and had these symptoms had at least one extra copy of this alpha tryptase gene.
So what really got us confused and wondering what was going on is that in some of the families, the mom and the dad of an affected patient both had high tryptase and both had the extra copy of tryptase. And so we were confused, how could that be if this is a rare disorder? What are the odds? We looked into a database that's here at the NIH of healthy volunteers, and we did this test on hundreds of people. And to our shock, it was present in maybe 4 to 6% of the folks we looked in.
You know, 5% of the population is a lot of people. Do that many people have the symptoms that we see in our families? And the answer is no, but many do. And surprisingly, more than we would have thought did. So we really think there's a strong signal in terms of the association between tryptase and many of these symptoms.
This research helped answer the first question, which is what's really going on. That's now our chance to try to take a step back from bringing in all of these patients up to now moving into the next stage, which is what are the things we can do to fix this? And now we look forward to the long but important process of moving to the next phase of trying to cure this.